Welcome everybody to the Searching 101 workshop. This workshop will introduce you to basic search techniques for conducting research in the library's Roadrunner search. So we will be using Roadrunner to demonstrate these search techniques, but let me remind you that these techniques should apply to most other databases as well. I do recommend following up this workshop with Searching 102. And if you need a more general explanation of the library and its resources, I definitely recommend the library orientation workshop. Before we begin, let me point out the various ways that you can get in touch with the library staff. That's located here on the right-hand side of the screen. You can contact us through Ask a Librarian, which is highly recommended because that way we can provide you with example searches or add attachments if you need an attached document. You can email us, you can do a live chat, you can call us, you can text us, or you can set up an individual research consultation. Now, these are most beneficial for doctoral students who have already done significant research on their own. But these are all the options for getting in contact with us. My name is Amanda Bizet, and I am one of the reference librarians here at the NCU Library. We do have a number of learning objectives today, and those are located in your workshop outline. If you don't have your workshop outline in front of you, that's certainly okay. Let me demonstrate how to access those workshop outlines. You're going to go to Research Help, Learn the Library, and then on the left-hand side of the screen, you'll see the library workshop videos. If you were to click on that link, that would bring you to all of our workshop recordings. So just like before I mentioned following up with Searching 102, if you're unable to attend a live session, definitely feel free to come here and view a recorded session. Remember, if you need a general overview of the library, you might want to check out the library orientation workshop. And if you do view one of these recorded sessions, you can certainly provide us with feedback on that recording using the library workshop feedback survey down here on the bottom left. We always welcome your feedback on our live and recorded sessions. If you're attending this live, you will receive an email tomorrow asking you to take this brief survey as well. So we are here looking at the recorded sessions, but I also wanted to point out the outlines on the left-hand side of the screen. So if you did need to access the Searching 101 workshop outline, you can do so right here. And on that workshop outline, we do have a number of learning objectives that we will be covering tonight. Upon completion of this workshop, you will know how to access the research process pages for preparing to search, access and use the library's Roadrunner search, effectively conduct keyword and subject searches, select appropriate database search limiters, effectively conduct database searches involving Boolean operators, truncation and phrases, search for a publication using the library's Find a Resource tool, and finally locate dissertations within the library. So let's go ahead and begin. I'm going to go to the Research Help drop-down menu and go to the research process. This provides a thorough overview of the research process, starting with finding your research topic and going down to producing scholarly research and everything in between in this research process. But what this workshop pertains to is the preparing to search section. So if you need a reminder of any of the techniques that are covered here in Searching 101, as well as those covered later in Searching 102, you can always return to these pages. So if you need a reminder about search limits, keyword searching, Boolean operators, etc. Each of these techniques has their own page. So now that we've seen that, let's go ahead and start doing a search using the library's Roadrunner search. Roadrunner is a great starting point for your research because it searches most of the library's database content simultaneously, including articles, ebooks, and videos. I do want to point out, however, that some databases contain information that cannot be displayed in the Roadrunner search interface. So Roadrunner results exclude databases with special content such as Merchant Online, Reference USA, as well as many academic videos and full-text dissertations. Therefore, we'll see how to access the dissertations later. But again, using Roadrunner is the best starting point for any research because it will retrieve the most results. And again, the search strategies that we're going to be using here in Roadrunner today will apply to other databases. So let's start out right here with a search for job satisfaction. So we will take a very broad topic and use all of our search strategies to narrow down our results. So I'm just going to go ahead and press submit. On our search results screen, before we start talking about our results and narrowing down our topic, I do want to point out the research starter at the top of the screen. Research starters are broad overviews of particular topics, and they are only accessible within the library's Roadrunner search results, meaning you can't access this content in any other databases or any other way. You will only see it if you have searched broadly for a topic within the Roadrunner search. So I'm going to click more so we can take a look at that job satisfaction research starter. Research starters are, again, broad overviews, and they typically come from some sort of reference book. So typically something like a handbook or an encyclopedia. These broad overviews are something, though, that you can confidently cite in your academic research. This particular one is coming from the Salem Press Encyclopedia. This is an academic resource, so you can comfortably cite it in your research, versus something like Wikipedia, which you will not want to cite in your research. It's always okay to consult sources like Wikipedia, but you would not want to cite it. So let me go back to our results screen because I just wanted to point out that research starter. And now we need to start talking about our search limiters.